Thank you for participating in Windsor's second Ride for Diabetes research in support of JDRF. I'm Angelo Versa from AM800, and along with Jamie McClay from DJ Ignited of Fire Studio Productions, will be your MC and DJ for today. Really, really happy to be part of this event. I heard it's the most fun you can have while riding a bike. I want to start off by introducing our key volunteer here in Windsor, Ride Chair Jamie Drysdale of Sunlight Financial.
The second annual Windsor JDRF ride here in Windsor. It's a pleasure to have everybody here, and just had a quick speech here for everybody. On behalf of the volunteer Windsor Ride Cabinet, I'd like to thank you all for coming to today's event. You are a large part of the success of this ride and the national target ride of $7.5 million and locally of $60,000 that we're going to bring to the JDRF Foundation. I just want to say a quick thanks to my cabinet, Tina Asparakis at Devonshire Mall, Scott Collier and Jenny Manello, part of Sunlight Financial with me, and I can't leave out Wendy Cunningham, who's done a fantastic job of the JDRF ride and bringing this ride together. So I wish everybody well today. Pedal fast, pedal hard, and have a lot of success going forward, and we're trying to get this ride bigger and better each and every year. On a personal note, my dad is the second oldest living juvenile diabetic in Canada. He's had it for over 63 years now. So this is a big part of me and a big part of my life. And the success of this ride means a lot to me. So try to get your friends and family out in the years to come. We'll try to get this event bigger and better. Thanks for participating.
Introduce Margaret Fitzpatrick, JDRF Regional Manager of Southwest Ontario, to say a few words of thanks to JDRF.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the second annual Ride for Diabetes Research. I just want to very quickly thank you, because of the efforts of passionate volunteers like you, JDRF Canada has been able to achieve great strides in diabetes treatment since our founding in 1974. As the leader of the T1D community, JDRF unifies the global efforts to cure, better treat, and prevent type 1 diabetes, encompassing the disease at every life stage. Thanks to all of you for your commitment and dedication to JDRF, and events like this are only successful because of people like you. So on behalf of JDRF, I'd like to say thank you to our key volunteer, Mary Licata, and her husband, Rico Licata, and her team of volunteers. Thank you very much. And I'd also like you to give yourself a big round of applause for all of the hard work and the proceeds that you're bringing in today. So thank you very much.
Let's take a few moments to thank some of our key supporters who helped make today's Ride for Diabetes research possible. Devonshire Mall, who donated the premises, equipment, and even the tent over our heads. Subway restaurants and the local franchisee owners who will help us and feed us delicious sandwiches after we work up an appetite. Tim Hortons, operated as TJ Enterprises, and franchisee Chris Kirwana for donating our breakfast today, as well as all the beverages that will help keep us not from being too thirsty this afternoon. Thanks also to our platinum sponsor, AM800 Radio, for their honor advertising leading up to this event, and also the A-Team, who came out and will be more provide more fun throughout this afternoon. I'd also like to thank Jamie McClain, DJ Ignited of Fire Studio Productions, for helping to keep us rocking under the tent today. This is Jamie's second year volunteering his services for the ride. Now let's take a few moments to meet the 2013 JDRF ambassadors to share with you what your efforts mean to them. Please join me in giving a warm welcome to mother and daughter, Stacy Sorrentino and Brooke Chamberlain.
As you mentioned, I'm Stacy, this is Brooke. We have a couple things to say. We do have it written down, so please work with us.
of the JDRF this year. This is my daughter who is the junior. I have been trying to put the word out there, especially for my daughter. It turns things around a lot when you end up having a child that has diabetes rather than just taking care of yourself. So when Bliss became diagnosed with diabetes just 2.5 years ago, it's made me empower myself to get out and just let people know what it's all about. I was diagnosed when I was 22, so I had it for 3 months. Signs that you have when you have diabetes, and sure enough, I was like, oh dang, I got all those. Went to an emergency, my sugar was at 27 when I was first diagnosed. It's done. I went to the emergency room, my sugar was 27, ended up getting my first insulin shot right there on the spot, and there was definitely no turning back at that point. We have to remember that not every day is a bad day. There are better days than not so bad. And we do need our family. This is a big thing. We need our family to know what signs and symptoms that we deal with when we have low blood sugars. And we're grumpy. We're combative sometimes. And it's very difficult to get that point across. So when Brooke is grumpy, I can usually just get her sugar low. It's not as tough as it looks. It is an everyday, every second job, and that's what makes it tough. So I'm going to hand this over to Brooke, and bear with her. She's very nervous.